Welcome back to Wives Class 2. In this class, we are going to learn interrogative and imperative sentences. How do we change a sentence from active voice to passive voice in both the models? Here, in interrogative, I am going to introduce you four different models, like do does means simple present tense, did simple past tense, with all the other modal auxiliaries, with all the other auxiliaries besides WH questions. One by one, we are going to discuss. See the sentences on the board. Do they help me? This is the interrogative sentence. The interrogative sentence started with do. Do. When we find do or does in interrogative sentence of active voice, you understand and remember the given sentence is in simple present tense. Simple present tense be forms are, is, or am. My dear student, as we discussed, the tense of passive voice does not change. Similarly, the mode of the sentence of active and passive must be same. Means, if they give you interrogative, you need to carry the interrogative sentence even into passive voice. If they give you assertive, you need to carry the same assertive into passive. If they give you imperative, you need to carry the same imperative mode into passive voice. Now, the given sentence is interrogative, it is clear, and the sentence started with do. If any sentence starts with do or does in active voice, remember they are to be replaced with any one of the suitable be forms, they are present be forms. So I need to replace do and restart my passive voice. Before I choose a suitable be form, I have to see the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice? The object of active voice is you. It's a plural. As the object of active voice is going to be taken as the subject of passive voice, you need to have subject verb agreement. Hence, I need to take only R out of these three. So, once after I confirm what is the be form that I need to take, then I have to start my passive voice. What is the passive voice? R. Then this other rules are as it is. Remember, other rules are as it is. Object of active voice will become subject of passive voice. What is the subject? You. Are you. Already be form is taken. Already be form is taken to start the sentence to convey interrogative mode. Then what is the third form of the verb given? The third form of the verb given is helped. Helped. Are you helped? Then we generally write the preposition by and the object form of the subject is them. Try to remember, we need to carry the same model even into passive voice. So question mark is compulsory. See the second sentence. When we see the second sentence, even the second sentence started with does. So when the sentence started with the do or does, replace them with is, or, am, present, be forms. So, before I choose my suitable be form, I have to see the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice in second sentence? It is pictures. It's plural or singular? Plural. Then I have to take plural be form R only when I wanted to start my sentence into passive. Then R. Then what about does? I am writing the suitable be form in the place of does itself. So, R, then same changes. Object will be taken as subject. The pictures. Once after writing are the pictures, I need to take my third form of the verb. What is the third form of the verb? Draw, drew, drawn. By her. This is the answer. Question mark. Don't forget. You have to carry the same tone even into the passive. Let us see the next sentence. Do you solve this problem? Again, the sentence started with do. So do must be replaced with any one of the suitable be forms. I need to see the object of active voice. This problem is a singular. When this problem is a singular, I have to take singular be form, that is. Then do must be replaced with is. Is this problem solved? Is this problem solved by you? This is the answer. And the last sentence, does she sing songs? Again, the sentence started with does. Does has to be replaced with suitable be form of present simple. What are the suitable be forms? Is, were, am. Then what is the object of active voice? Songs. Is it a plural object or singular object? Plural object. Then I should take plural be form. So I should take are songs sung by, or songs sung by her? Question mark. Do not forget to take the question mark. Now let me explain you with the simple past tense. See these two sentences. Did they post the letter? The sentence started with did. Did represents simple past tense because it's second form of the verb. Simple past tense be forms are was or were. So as we discussed how to change simple present tense do or does, similar way we change the sentences even in simple past tense. So before I choose my suitable be form, I have to depend on the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice? The letters. Letters, is it a singular or plural? Plural. Hence I need to take plural be form were. So in the place of did, I need to start my sentence with plural be form which I chose, were. Then write the object. Were the letters? Were the letters? And what is the third form of the verb given in active voice? The third form of the verb given in active voice is posted. Posted. Were the letters posted by them? This is the answer. Shall I put the question mark or full stop? Compulsory question mark, because we need to carry the same tense and same model. Let us see the second sentence. Did she give a pen? Did she give you a pen? Did she give you a pen? The sentence started with did in active voice. Whenever the sentence started with did in active voice, you have to replace did it with was or were. Based on what? Based on the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice? The object of active voice is singular. So I have to take singular be form. So then in the place of was, I need to start my passive with was. Was, then immediately an object of active voice has to be taken as the subject of passive voice. A pen, was a pen. Given by her, and question mark. Don't forget, tense and mode of active voice and passive voice must be same. Let us see other models, other tenses apart from simple past and simple present. Are you doing this project? This is the question asked in active voice. As we discussed, the tense of passive voice also would be the same of active voice. Then you identify and find out what is the tense of this sentence. What is the tense of this sentence? The tense of sentence are plus v1 plus ing form, that is present continuous tense. If active voice is given in present continuous tense, passive voice also should be in present continuous tense. Tense must not change in active voice and passive voice. Remember this. Are you doing this project? If other tenses are given in active voice, passive voice must be started with any one of the helping verbs of that particular tense. What are the helping verbs of present continuous tense? Is, are, am. Is, are, am. Then I have to choose any one of these three helping verbs based on the object. What is object here? This project. This project is a singular. When this project is a singular, I have to start my sentence with the singular helping verb, that is. So instead writing are, I am taking is because the object is singular. So is this project, is this project, once after writing the object of active voice as the subject of passive voice, as it is already in the interrogative model, I need to take the suitable be form. What is the suitable be form of continuous tense? Suitable be form of continuous tense is being, B-I-N-G, being. So is this project being? So once after writing being, then what is the V3 form of do, did it, done? Is being done by you? So question mark is compulsory. The second sentence gives you the same kind of tense. Is she reading a novel? Is reading. These two words give you information that the sentence belongs to present continuous tense. Once after you confirm the tense of the sentence, then start rewriting the sentence basing on the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice? A novel. A novel is a singular. As the object is a singular, I have to take singular helping verb only. What is the singular helping verb here? Again is. Out of these three, singular helping verb is. So I can start my sentence with the same helping verb because the object of active voice is singular. So is a novel. Is a novel. Once after writing the object of active voice as the subject of passive voice, then I should write my be form. What is my be form? As the given sentence is in continuous tense, as the given sentence is in continuous tense, be form is being. So a novel is being read by her. Question mark is compulsory as we need to carry the same kind of sentence. Let us see the second sentence. Was she drawing pictures? Was drawing. These two words will give you information that the sentence belongs to past continuous tense. What are the past continuous tense helping verbs? I'm talking about here helping verbs. Was, are, were are the helping verbs. Was, are, were are the helping verbs past continuous tense. Based on the object of active voice, I need to choose any one of these two. As the object of active voice is a plural, I need to take were in the place of was. So I do not take was. The reason is the object of active voice is plural. So plural helping verb is were. Were, after writing were pictures, then I have to take the object. Were pictures, as we discussed, it is a continuous tense. In continuous tense, be form is being. Were pictures being drawn by her? Question mark is must. Let us learn how to change the sentence from active voice to passive voice with the WH questions. My dear students, when a question is asked in active voice with a WH question or with a WH word, you start writing the passive voice with the given same WH word without changing. Once after you write the WH word into passive voice, then the question left out is verbal question only. See the first sentence. What do we observe with the first sentence? The first sentence gives us the information that is WH question in active voice. When the sentence in active voice is given with the WH, rewrite the passive voice with the same WH word. So you take same WH word into passive voice. Then you start the passive with what. Once after you write the what, see the remaining sentence. Have you written? This is verbal question. In verbal question, what is the tense of the question? The tense of the question and the tense of the sentence is present perfect. My dear students, whenever the question is asked with the what, imagine the object is third person singular. Imagine the object is third person singular. So you have to use third person singular helping verb, that is has. Then you take what has. As we know, perfect tenses be forms. Perfect tenses be form is been. Then immediately after writing the helping verb, you have to take the be form, been. What has been written? What has been written by you? This is the answer. Question mark. Never forget to take the question mark into passive voice. Next sentence. Where did she buy this book? What type of sentence is it? Interrogative. WH question. Any question in active voice started with the WH word, rewrite the sentence with the same WH word into passive, then write where. Once after you complete writing where into passive voice, then what is the left out question? The left out question is, did she buy this book? This is verbal question. This is a verbal question. How did you change when a sentence started with did in verbal question? Did has to be replaced with was a verb. So because it's a past simple tense, as it is a past simple tense, we have to use the suitable be forms or was a verb. Then this book is a singular object. As it is a singular object, you need to take singular be form. So where was. In the place of did, what did I write? Was. Why did I write? The given sentence is in simple past tense. So did must be replaced with was or were with a suitable be form. Where was this book? Once after writing the suitable be form, write the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice? This book. Then you write this book. Where was this book? Third form of the verb of active voice is bought. Bought by her. Shall we use question mark? Yes, compulsory. You need to carry the same model into passive voice. When a question is asked with who in active voice, my dear students, before you start converting the sentence, change who as by whom. Who as by whom, and then start writing the sentence. Who can answer my question? Here there is a question with WH for who. It has to be changed as by whom. By whom. Once after writing who, and what is the left out question? The left out question is verbal question. When the left out question is verbal, you see what type of question is it, what is the tense of this question. The tense of this question is simple future, like modal auxiliary. When the sentence is with modal auxiliary, you rewrite the sentence with the same. By whom, can, once after writing can, then take the object of active voice. Can my cushion? Can my cushion? Then what is the be form with modal auxiliaries? Be form with modal auxiliaries is be. Be answered. Again, question mark. Only difference is who is changed as by whom, and with the same we need to start the passive voice. Let us learn the last and final model of active voice and passive voice, that is imperative model. If a sentence is in active voice is given in imperative, then how to start and how to rewrite the sentence in passive voice? When a sentence in active voice is imperative, there are two ways to start the passive voice. You can start the sentence with let. My dear students, when you start the sentence with let, after writing the word let in passive voice, you have to take the object of active voice. Once after taking the object of active voice, you have to write only be form be. After writing the only be form be, you have to write the third form of the active voice. Remember, this is the first way of converting or rewriting a sentence from active voice to passive voice using let. It is also called let model. Sometimes you can straight away start the sentence with the object of active voice. So you just forget about the first sentence, that is with let. You can start the sentence with the object of active voice. Once you start a sentence with object of active voice, you have to use the modal auxiliaries like must, should, might to convey the same meaning. Once after you write the suitable modal auxiliary, then you have to write be form and V3 form of. The other changes will take place as usual. Let me show you in one or two sentences how do we change them. See the sentence, close the door. The given sentence is in imperative model. The given sentence is in imperative model. How do we know the given sentence is in imperative model? As I already mentioned, imperative sentences start with main verbs. So what is the verb of active voice? Close. What is the object of active voice? The door. So if I wanted to start the sentence with let, then I should start my sentence with let. What should I do after writing let? After writing let, I should write the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice? The door. Then I take the word the door. Let the door. Once after writing the object of active voice, what I am supposed to do? I need to take the be form. In imperative sentence, we use the only be form is be. No other be forms are used in imperative except be as a be form. So let the door be. Let the door be. And then once after writing be form, I am supposed to write third form of active voice. What is the third form of active voice? Close, closed, closed. This is the answer. Again, full stop. Mood of the sentence need to be carried into the passive voice even. So the answer is let the door be closed. Instead writing the sentence with let, let me start writing the sentence with the object of active voice. What is the object of active voice? The door. Then I can take the door as my subject of passive voice. Once after writing the object of active voice as the subject of passive voice, I should use the modal auxiliaries either should or must. The door should be closed. With this you can understand, I can start my sentence with let. When I start my sentence with let, follow these steps. If I start with object, you have to carry immediately after writing the object of active voice as the subject of passive voice, you have to write the modal auxiliaries. Once after writing the modal auxiliaries, suitable be form is be. No other be form has to be used. Similarly, let us see the second sentence. Help the poor. This is the second sentence. If you start the sentence with let, how do you write let? Then what is the object of active voice? The poor. Then you take the poor as it is. Let the poor. Let the poor. Once after writing the object of active voice, I have to write my suitable be form. What is my suitable be form? Be. Let the poor be. Once after writing my suitable be form, I have to write third form of active voice. What is the third form of active voice? Help. Help. Third form is helped. So this is the answer. Instead writing with let, if I wanted to start the sentence in passive voice with the poor, so I am taking the object as it is. With the object of active voice, even I can start my passive voice in imperative sentence. If I start my passive voice with the object of active voice, so I am not taking let into my passive. So I take the poor. The poor. The poor, it's an obligation. Then you can use the modal auxiliary should. The poor, or you can take a compulsion, it is must. The poor, you can take the word must. It is a modal auxiliary. Once after taking the modal auxiliary, what is the be form go with the modal auxiliary? The be form go with the modal auxiliary is only be. The poor must be helped. So my dear students, with this you can easily understand how to write a sentence from active voice to passive voice in imperative model. And let me show you the one more sentence so that you can get complete clarity. Complete the work. Complete is the main verb. The work is an object. I can write my passive voice with let. If they ask you rewrite the sentence using let and write, happily I can write using let. Once after writing let, I need to take the object of active voice as the subject of passive voice. Then let the work. What is the be form? Go with let. Be. Let the work be. Then third form of the verb is completed.